Today we're going to cover the basics of creating a customized theme in WordPress. First, I'll show you how to create a simple theme using only index.php and style.css files. We'll focus on how to add theme information to the style.css file and how to see this information in the WordPress admin panel. This information will include important details, such as the theme's name, author description, and will make your theme more recognizable and professional. I am currently on the themes page of a website, and when we enter this page, you will see an area where the themes that can be used within the site are listed. Let's take a look at what is in this area. There is the name of the theme. When we enter the theme details, there is some information such as who the theme was made by, the description of the theme, tags, and there is an image on the left side. Now, we will prepare a theme similar to this. Let's go to the folder where our WordPress site is installed. You can either connect through the actual result or you can do it on your local computer. Both methods are the same. I go into the content folder, here I go into the themes folder, and as you can see, we can see the three themes we saw on the previous page here. Now, since we are going to create a new theme, I will create a new folder here. I right-click on the folder, I create a folder with new folder. Let's name the site. We will name it Ekinyeljin. Let's use all lowercase characters if possible, and let's not use spaces. We have created our folder. Now I will transfer this folder to Visual Studio Code so that we will work with codes. I take this folder, I drag it here, the folder is here. Now I will be able to create new files from here. But I want to follow the developments on the other side instantly. I come to this page and refresh it, there is no result. The reason is, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we need two basic files to create a WordPress theme, style.css and index.php. If one of these two files is missing, the WordPress system will not recognize this folder as a theme. Therefore, I will create two files. One of them is index.php and the other is style.css. When I check the folder, I can see that both files are created here. Now let's look at the other side again. I refresh the page, and here it has created an extra theme by putting the name of the folder here. If we look at the theme details, it looks like this because we don't give any information, so it looks empty. We can say that index.php is the most basic file of WordPress. This is the file where we determine how to display the home page of your site and other content pages managed by WordPress. Style.css is the file containing the CSS codes required for the style and appearance of the theme. But besides these features, this file has another important function for WordPress. This is where information such as theme title, description, author, version, etc., that we have not yet seen on the themes page is defined. We are going to define it now. And making these definitions correctly will determine the identity and appearance of the theme. These are the codes. These codes are also available on WordPress's own codex page, and we'll make some edits here. Through these definitions, we will be able to see this information in the Add Theme section in the WordPress administration panel. I'm making edits right away. I'm writing the theme name here. The name of your theme that will appear in the WordPress admin panel and on the themes page must be a unique and meaningful name. In this field, you can write the address of a website where the theme is introduced or can be downloaded. If you are developing the theme yourself, you can put your own name here. If you are doing this under a company, you can write the name of the company. Again, I will write my name here. We can add the author's or company's website here. We can write a description text. It doesn't matter if it is short or long. I wrote this as a personal website. You can add a version number. You can change this number with the updates you make in the theme. It can remain 1.0. These two fields are where you can enter the license type of the theme and the address where the license information is located. Usually a GPL or GPL compatible license is used. What we call the GPL license is the general public license, which is the most widely used license type in the WordPress community. WordPress is free software, and this means that this theme also has a free license. At the address at the bottom, it actually redirects to a text of the GPL license, which is the official website of GNU. That's why they stay like this as standard. You can read that license if you are interested. And finally, there's the tags and text domain area. In the tags section, you can enter a few tags that describe the function of the theme. For example, it expresses here that there are two columns in a column within the pages. We can understand this from these texts. Of course, you can delete them if you don't have them, or add new ones if you have them. There's a sidebar or a responsive website. You can specify all of that here. I'm going to enter Ekin Yaljin here, and then I'm going to save the page. I saved it with Ctrl S, shortcut. Now I'm going to go back to the admin panel, and I'm going to close this page. I'm going to refresh the page. Look, this has changed. It was the folder name just now, and now it's written whatever the theme name is. If we look at the theme details, we can see all the values we entered here. Theme name, version number, who made the theme. That information is also here. He added the description part here and added the tags here. Now let's come to the next job. Look, you see an empty field on the left side. What should be in this field? It should be a screenshot of the theme itself or a logo. But we have this field empty. We can put anything in this area. It is better than looking empty. That's why I'm opening Photoshop first. You can create an image there yourself by following these instructions in any visual editor. The size of the image should be 1200 in width and 900 in height. 72 dpi can remain. We will be able to see any image we will add here in the theme settings in the administration panel. I put this logo as an example and assume that you have prepared an image in this way, or you can take a screenshot of the theme you have made and put it here again. I'm going to save this image as a PNG, and then I'm going to go into the theme we created, and I'm going to name it screenshot, and this name is also very important. We saved our image as screenshot.png, and then I come back to this page. I refresh the page, and when I refresh the page, I can see the image of the screenshot.png file we just created here as the theme image. Again, when we enter the theme details, I will see the same image here. The important points to add this image here must be named screenshot, and this file must be saved in the main folder of the theme. After doing this, WordPress will automatically adopt the file using this name as the theme image. That's it for this video. I explained the steps you can do to make your theme look professional. I hope it was useful. If this video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. See you in the next tutorial.